I'm Steve Bijou. Coming up on Down Home Corner, Campbellton's Byron Christopher has written a fascinating and compelling book called The Man Who Mailed Himself Out of Jail. It's the story of Richard Lee McNair, murderer, convict, and world's greatest escape artist, who was captured by RCMP in Campbellton in 2007. A case so famous, it drew a huge spotlight and the world's media to the North Shore, including the TV show America's Most Wanted. Byron's book tells McNair's story and journey across the U.S. and Canada in fascinating detail, all leading up to his capture in Campbellton. Byron is the gatekeeper of McNair's story. No other journalist has been granted access to the King of Escape. The Man Who Mailed Himself Out of Jail by Byron Christopher is available on Amazon and soon to be a TV miniseries being produced by Soledad O'Brien's company, SOB Productions. In this 10-minute clip, Byron talks to me about an encounter with some locals in Louisiana while doing research for the book. Now you can hear me laughing through all of this, but what you can't see are the tears that are coming down my cheek. I've lost it so bad. Anyway, it's not a story featured so much in the book, as Byron says, but it's hilarious, and it's kind of a Down Home Corner exclusive, so I hope you enjoy it. Warning: contains adult issues and is definitely not politically correct. So, if you are a snowflake, don't listen. Stop now, or you could be forever changed. I was just struck by how cliche and scripted it all sounds, but it's real life. And sometimes, that's funnier than anything you can write. Because it's real.
It was a Friday night, I remember, and it was evening, and the sun was setting fast. And I wanted to go to the tracks in the area where McNair walked down, talk to people living along the tracks if they saw him. So I
where that famous video is, right? Exactly that spot.
No, it's only about a block away from there.
Okay.
A block north of there. That's where I stopped the car, and there were boys having a bonfire. There were about half a dozen of them. It was dark, and flames are just like stupid high. And there is a shack there. I mean, this is the other side of the tracks, poor people. You know, so I walked in through the dark, approaching these guys. Someone noticed me, and one of the brave ones approached me and met me halfway and just stared at me. It wasn't a welcome sign. So whatever, I opened up by saying, you know, your bonfire, you can see it from the International Space Station. And the guy said, are you the law? I said, no, I'm not the law. I'm a reporter. He said, we ain't never had a reporter here before. These are his exact words. And I said, I'm here to talk about a fugitive who escaped and who walked down these tracks. And the guy said, Richard Lee McNair.
There.
I said, oh, you've heard about it? He said, yeah, he's famous here. And I said, did you see him? Nope. We all know about it. They all gathered around, these half dozen guys. I pulled up my laptop, put it on the hood of an old pickup truck there, and said, these are pictures of McNair. And I told him I was writing a book. And one of them, a little chubby guy, early 20s, he said, am I going to be in the book? I said, I don't know. It turned out his name is Jonathan. So they said, yeah, he looks like Arlin. I said, who's Arlin? He said, cops was chasing Arlin that time because he looked like McNair, and he sure does. I said, oh, really? Who's this Arlin guy? And he said, oh, he lived around here, and he was running. And I said, running? It's like 100 degrees that day. He said, yeah, because we was chasing him. I said, you were chasing Arlin? Yeah, I caught him in bed with Mama, like his mother. Oh, okay. Getting personal here.
Hmm.
He said, yeah, we were running. I was chasing him. And the police saw him running, so they cornered him in those small vehicles.
So,
like
so you, meet,
you meet the guys who are chasing a guy named Arlin who's been sleeping with one of their moms.
Banging his mom. Yeah, they
banging
caught him
his mom. And the cops think that because this guy's running that he's McNair.
Yeah, and he looks like McNair, and he runs like McNair. He's almost like a deer, you know. He runs really fast. And I said, "Where's your mama? I'd like to talk to her." She's in jail right now. I said, "Jail? Yeah, she goes there. You know, she gets drinks a bit and flags cars." And I said, "What's that?"
This is
you run out on the street, Mr. Bojangles, or something.
You know, like oh my God.
This is an incredible story, but interesting as hell. And anyway, she said, "Yeah, Mama does that." And they warned her. Yeah, she gets drunk and runs out on the street and stops the traffic. So they said, "You do that again, we're going to put you in jail." So they did. As I said, "So your mama's in jail?" "Yeah, she's in jail." I said, "Where does Arlin live? He lives around here?" And, "Oh, no, he lives with his mama in the country." "Oh, okay. Oh, is it around here?" And, "Well, you'd never find it. It's like 5 miles out or something." I said, "Would you take me there?" "Yeah, yeah, I'll take you there."
Take me to Arlin's and his mom's house.
Yeah. So anyway, I go around next day. I want to meet this Arlin guy. He's a good part of the story, you know.
No kidding.
See if he looks like McNair. Oh. And he was like roughly the same age. So, okay. So this con, I call him a con. He sits in the front of my car, slams the door. He said, "I'll take you out there." And then I hear bang, bang behind me. I look around, the two doors are closed. There's two guys there. Jonathan, whose mother he was banging, and his father, whose wife he was banging. And I said, "What are you doing here?" They didn't even ask to sit in my car. They just made themselves at home in my rental, my Toyota. And they said, "You're going to need backup." Okay.
Oh, my God, they got you back.
So I drive out there. It's actually about 7 miles, paved highway, and then you hit the driveway, which is a dirt driveway, and it leads a long driveway, and it leads down to this house that has a sloping veranda, just like in the movies.
Oh my God. And I'm making
my way down this gravel driveway, and the rocks are crunching under the wheels. And
dogs are barking in the distance.
"There's Arlin, there's Arlin." And there was a guy running, was he fast. He ran across the yard. He didn't even touch his steps. He just flew right up on the veranda, you know, the floor, and into the house. And he said, "That's Arlin." I said, "Okay." I get out of the car, and I walk up the steps, and I knock on the door, screen door, and this woman comes out. Steve,
she had
muscles that would be like twice what you and I have, you know, in her arms. Kind of a heavy set woman.
"You scared my son,
Arlin." "Hi, how are you?" Not like that. She says, "What do you want?" I said, "I'd like to speak to your son." And then she blows a puff away from her cigarette. "About what?" I said, "Well, your son was an innocent victim. He was chased by the police. They thought he was this fugitive, Richard Lee McNair. But he was an innocent victim," I said. "Oh." And then she turns to or tilts her head toward the screen door and says, "Arlin, get your ass out here." It doesn't say come out here. So out comes Arlin. He's like mid-40s, 47 or so. He's about McNair's age at the time. And he comes out. I was shocked. He was crying. Tears running down his face. He was so scared he was crying. And he comes out. But one moment I pulled out the mic and got the recorder going. And I said, "What happened there, Arlin?" "Well, now he's Mr. Tough Guy."
"Oh, yeah.
I told them cops, you don't mess with me." You know, and all this stuff. It was a great interview. It was all bull, but it was tense.
Oh, wow.
Because the man, the woman he's banging, her husband is like 4 feet away from him with his arms folded, glaring at him. So I thought, there's going to be a punch up here. Garland's brother come out, and he looked really inbred, you know, inbred. Because it was just so tense. And I said, "Hey, guys, would you like some Mountain Dew?" "Yeah." I said, "I got some in the back of my car."
Oh, you weren't being cliche or nothing, were you?
No, no, no. I didn't know Mountain Dew. I bought it at Walmart.
Mountain Dew.
And so the con jumped down, and he went over, and he's throwing these cans around, Mountain Dew, and everyone's cracking them open. They're having a good time.
Hey, you guys are hicks. You guys are hicks. You want some Mountain Dew?
True story. Anyway. So they get razzing Arlin. They say, Arlin, there's a pond over there. Is there a gator there? Yeah. Well, go on down there and wrestle that gator. No, I don't want to do that. Oh, come on, Arlin, you can do it. They're razzing him, you know. He's stupid,
They're performing for you now, right? They know.
Everyone's guzzling the Mountain Dew and peace is restored. All is forgiven about banging his wife and that stuff. So we get back in the car and I take a picture of Arlin. Can I get a picture of you? Yeah, he stands by the house there and I take a picture of him. We get back in the car. The doors are slammed. It's quiet. I'm making a roundabout turn there on their grass and I see them craning their necks. They say, look at all the lights on the tree there. Christmas lights. We can come back and steal them, I heard one guy say. And then one guy said, you know, Arlin would have took a better picture had he put his teeth in.
Oh, man, I want to meet Arlin. Bucket list stuff. Don't miss the full interview with Byron Christopher on DownhomeCorner.com September 2020. And as a bonus, we'll give away 3 copies of Byron's book, The Man Who Mailed Himself Out of Jail, when we release the full show. Stay tuned for more details. Down Home Corner, everybody has a story, and we are all connected.